It's good to meet my old friend, Dr. Hui, today to talk about the past of medical oncology. And now is the present. And Dr. Hui would like to share with us the present of the medical oncology and the future. So the first trained, locally trained medical oncologist in Hong Kong, Dr. Hui.
So when I first graduated, I think I graduated in 1993. Yeah, my first is entered the oncology field. Yeah, there's no medical oncologist in Hong Kong. Okay, actually, I just entered a department which they basically is clinical oncologist. Mm-hmm. There's no medical oncologist. Mm-hmm. Because at that time, there's most cancer treated by surgery, and then maybe some for by radiation. Yeah. There are not much systemic therapy. At that time, only chemotherapy. We don't have targeted therapy or immunotherapy 30 years ago. So there's very little people. If you do medical oncologists, you probably don't have anything.
So you do so very brave, Dr. Hui.
Yeah, at that time, I thought, this is something a magnetic. It's many people, they were told their cancer cannot be inoperable, surgery cannot help, and it's end of their treatment. Yeah, I think there's much more
to do.
To do here, yeah. So at that time, it's only the start of medical oncology. So Prince of Wales Hospital is actually the first medical oncology center. So we started medical oncology service here, then built up a training that. Today, I'm very glad that because the first center in Prince of Wales Hospital, then we have the second center as established in Queen Mary Hospital. And subsequently, we now have all the medical oncology training centers in all hospital authority. At least now we have probably six centers. Yeah, we have more trainees. So this year, I just look at the training law posts.
Okay. Yeah. You actually wrote the guidelines or...
Oh, yeah. There I was the initial part doing the medical oncology specialty board, doing the training chairman and none. Program director, we build up the program. At that time, we only have one center, two centers, three centers. At one time, we may not have one trainee a year or 1 year, no trainees. Then we now have nearly 20 trainees, more than a couple of trainees. Every center has two or three trainees. So the next month, we will have initially, we only have exit examination once per year. Some years, we don't have trainees. We don't have exams. Now, we do it twice a year. Next month, we will have six trainees exit. And every examination, usually more than six trainees or some interim exams. So we need more examiners to find a place to hold it. So this year, I think we have a very rich program in six centers. So we have more trainees. So I witnessed the development of medical oncology service in Hong Kong. So I think when I first graduated, the chemotherapy is little use. Some surgeon even do chemotherapy after operation. Yeah, simple chemotherapy. And most centers don't have medical oncologists. The chemotherapy may be given by surgeon or gynecologist. Some centers, they're given by clinical radiation oncologists, clinical oncologists. Mm. Now, with the increasing availability of more than chemotherapy, targeted therapy, systemic therapy, immunotherapy, and the more coming, the antibody drug conjugate bispecific, as the systemic therapy increases in capacity, and also our patient gets older. We now have geriatric oncology. They usually have more complicated medical comorbidity. There are many drug interventions. Yeah, you need a physician with more knowledge with how to deal with medical complications. So it's easy to just get a drug, but how to manage the complications and keep patient on treatment and with the dose optimally deliver the treatment in time, maintain the dose intensity. This is important. It's not just you give the drug and then when the patient have problems, go into the hospital, you ask the physician to manage that. So with the increasing complexity of drug treatment, usually that's why we need a medical oncologist who focus on the drug management of cancer.
Yeah.
The surgery, you can focus the surgery, you have more sophisticated surgery. You have robotic surgery. You need more training on that. You focus then. You don't have time to know a lot of drugs.
Right.
And radiation, they have sophisticated 4DRT and SRT. They usually take more time to train the group. It's time we need a medical oncology course specialized in the drug management. And overall, for the optimal management of cancer, we probably need a multidisciplinary. It's a combined modality. Everybody will contribute then.
Right. You particularly mentioned several times we need sophisticated physician. So what about the training? So the medical oncologists, they start the training from internal medicine first?
Yeah. That's a difference between in medical oncologists. Basically, we're under the College of Physicians. So We the 6-year training, the first 3 years is general medicine.
Yeah, I mean
general physician training. Do the general rotation in medical department, do the emergency call, every rotate to cardiology, renal physician. So have overall exposure of how to manage the medical problems of patient. We have a solid foundation and pass the AC examination before you enter to a specialty training, learn the new things. So we usually emphasize our broad base medical training before we specialize on something highly sophisticated. That's our advantage in our training. So we are better positioned to manage a patient with more medical problems.
So Dr. Hui, what are the area that you are facing challenges today?
So for medical oncology in the old days, the problem is we don't have that many drugs to use. So every year there only one new drug approved by the FDA. So you spend many years to do research before some new treatment become available. So you don't have to learn too many drugs. But nowadays it's different. Every month we have a new drug coming in. Yeah. So it's a plethora of treatment options. So I will overlay how a trainee can cope that in the examination, they need to remember too many things. So I try to avoid asking too many factual things because these things, nowadays you can ask AI, you don't need to remember things, but it's good that you really emphasize the principle. You learn the horses, you learn the principles. Yeah. Instead of the facts, you can always check with your just mobile phone, everything, the knowledge database in your hand. You don't need to memorize, but you need to how to use it at the point of care.
Yeah, it's interpret.
Yeah. Then the other challenge is that there are so many options and many new drugs are very expensive.
Yeah.
And in the public hospital, there's some standard drugs, some special pharmacy that could even find the cause. So sometimes we need to face a patient, how to optimally treat this patient. We need to solve their financial burden. Yeah, we spend a lot of time on this. That's one of the challenges. Yeah, so
also,
actually, you asked about how to oncologist. I think the oncology will choose people. Yeah. Usually when people interact, are you really interested in oncology? Oncology is some specialty that is everybody's.
It's everybody.
You won't choose oncology lighthearted. It just take a try. It's not a job you want to try. People may try to do some job and find if they're interested or not. Yeah. For those people who are oncology, they need a park.
Yes.
Yeah. The best med. I think I have one stature here. Yeah. The best treatment. Keep it here. Yeah, this one. Yeah. How you say?
Yes. Very.
I think this is especially important for cancer. Most of the time, even with all the drugs, with surgery, cancer is a very difficult disease. Most of the time, it may not. You may help the patient. There are few patients, it may be cure. Nowadays, we're living the cancer, we're not in for cure. Most of the time, it's still fake. You can't save every fall. So the best medicine is a cheerful. Cheerful, you need a heart. You face the patient, you face your success, but most time you have problems. The patient may, you still, your treatment failed, the cancer coming back. Yeah. So it's not just a simple Shen Feng cut, it's just a cognitive medicine, people got away, yeah. It's a cardiologist, it's a surgery, either the patient died or the patient survived. Oncology is not a, it is a process.
It's a process.
You live with cancer, you need the drug, yeah. Even 5 years, the disease may be under control or cured. You don't know what's next. It's not just a one treatment.
You have to
yeah.
manage the patient, wake the patient.
Yeah. So it's an, it's stressful. Where yeah, you need to face a lot of difficulty, challenges. So we need something balanced. So I'm a fan of Star Wars and more. Because my age, the Star Wars, yeah. So, so you know, I keep all the figures of Star Wars, yeah. Because Star Wars, I believe that, it's a bit, there's something linking, connecting, yeah. There's something linking everything in ninjas, yeah.
Right, the universe.
Yeah, the universe. So when we face cancer, we usually do. You are not alone. Yeah, you're just treating cancer. So we link everything. You need your family. You need everything. Doctors, nurse, physician, multi different. Just you are not alone. So yeah. That's right.
The force be with you.
Yeah, really. Yeah, something. I'm a Christian, so we definitely need to.
Yeah.
That also helped me how to understand. In the old days, it's difficult to understand how spirit help you. But Star Wars, I think. They think there's something in the universe control everything. Yeah. You need your faith. Help you to overcome topical things.
Love. Man.
Yeah.
Very good. We are very close to China. So what's your view of the future? China.
Yeah. I think Hong Kong has a unique history and position. So the Hong Kong medical system is basically inherited from the Western training. And it also has, it's a point also has a close relationship with China. So we usually call it West meets East.
Yeah.
We have the both systems meet here. So we have a unique position. See, in the old days, my specialty is head and neck nasopharyngeal cancer. So nasopharyngeal cancer is rare in the West. It's common here. Then we do a lot of research in nasopharyngeal cancer. So we've done some of the pioneer studies, especially some treatment in nasopharyngeal cancer in the past 10 years. But now I can foresee that China is taking up, they learn the research, they develop a drug. Yeah.
Mm.
So in the, I think 10 years ago, in Guangzhou, the Shenzhen Cancer Center, they come to us, We are doing a lot of research. We do a lot of relationships and we do sister institutions. They are very humble to come to, even they do a study, they ask for our opinion. Now, they are doing more research where there are more drugs, new drugs, money, new drugs is coming in China. And they have a lot of patients there, yeah, and 10 times our patients. So they can do a study very quickly, very efficiently. We take many years to complete a phase 3 study. They only 1 or 2 years. So they are moving faster than us. Yeah.
And are more cost effective as well.
They have more manpower, they have the resources, they have the patient populations. So but we are still in a good collaboration because we have a close link with the Westpac. We will probably do more innovation and they will do it the large population studies. We will be more doing the early phase studies. And if they have more drugs, then we can also help them to test it, develop. So I think that the Greater Bay, the China, I think the government is also building up as a research hub. Yeah. I think it's scientific advance will only help when you collaborate. Yeah. Each of them have different strength. You know, it's usually the advancement happen in collaboration rather than each one of us working secret.
Yeah.
There's no secret science.
Okay, Doctor, I know many graduates, they would like to enter your specialty. So what advice you will give them and what kind of preparation they have to you?
So for a medical student who has interest in pursue a career in oncology general, not just medical, you can have clinical oncology or in surgery, I would advise them to study widely, equip themselves with all the basic tools, know everything, not just oncology. Yeah. You need to know the whole person to order to treat the patient. So usually I was usually go to attachment for the surgery, how they do treat cancer with surgery, do some radiation on us, how exposed to different specialties, cardiology, renal. It's always good you do some more general rotations, how you deal with emergency at your earlier stage, then before you commit on a specialties. Yeah, I think that's advice for. And for on medical oncology in general, we should need a more broad-based knowledge. Because you need to face many different complications, multi-organ and geriatric. Yeah, it's good if you attach some elderly people. Now more half of the cancer patients, elderly people. So you if you just know how to use drug, you will not understand treat the patient. It's not just the knowledge, it's your skills. Yeah. So you should learn the general skills before you specialize how to use the cancer drugs. Yeah. And then lastly, you probably need a cheerful heart to deal with especially elderly people. No.
Right. So thank you, Dr. Hui, for today's time for our interview. And the take-home message, very key message. A cheerful heart is good medicine. Dr. Hui, thank you.
Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to Oncodaily on YouTube. Hit the bell icon to stay updated.